Hello and welcome once more to my practical CCTV demonstrational lessons. I have here today two power supply units for CCTV camera installations. I have this particular one and I have this other type that we'll be using in this practical demonstration. And so basically in this demonstration, you'll get to understand the wiring concept of any kind of power supply unit, whereby we'll get to be able to interpret wiring guides as you may find on any kind of CCTV power supply unit. So I want us to start, but before we start, I want to get to introduce the tools that I will be using. I have here a couple of tools. I have a tester, which I will use to be able to screw my cables into the power supply units. I have a few other screwdrivers here, both flat and star screwdrivers. And then we have a cartridge knife for our cutting. And then as well, we have a cutting ply that we'll be using in the course of our demonstration. So this is the one that we'll be wiring first before we get to the second one. Every power supply unit receives the main AC power from any normal electricity socket and gives out the 12 volt part. So you have the main AC and then the main DC outputs, which are 12 volts outputs. So let's look at how this one is wired. This is the main AC side. When you lift up this bridge, this is the main AC side. When you look at it critically, you will see the L that is written in here, which is referring to the terminal here, this connector here. We have an N that is here, which refers to neutral for this connector. And then we have an F symbol, that is the symbol here, that is a stroke, a slash, and then strokes below it, which refers to F. So simply, this is the point where you put a cable like this kind of cable that is having three conductors. We have the live, the neutral, and then an F. So we need a three conductor or three core cable with the plug that we can plug onto a main electricity supply. So this kind of cable is what will fit into the mains AC side. And this cable can just be fed through the hole at the side of the system, and then we'll wire it into this kind of bridge. So let's get to do the wiring. The live is here, as I said, the neutral is here, and then the F. And when you take this cable that I am using to power it up as well, we have each conductor dedicated to live, neutral, and then the F. And these are conventions. In electrical conventions, normally brown stands for live, and then the blue stands for neutral, and then the green stroke yellow is normally the F in connection. It is important to do that because when you take the pin as well, there's a live pin, there's a neutral pin, and there's an F pin. So you need to do this kind of corresponding cable termination so that the right cable or the right line goes into the power supply unit. So that's said and done. Let's push in the cables into each of the bridges here. But before we do, I want to put the cables together well, twist it together to be firm. Let me do all of them together before we start putting them under each of the terminal blocks. So I'll first of all loose the first one here. When you loose it, you can just place the cable below it and then you tighten it down there firmly. As you tighten, you make sure it goes well. The neutral would also follow. I've loosed it also already. Okay, so place it below the neutral or the conductor that is corresponding to neutral, place it very well and tighten it also. Once it's tight, you are there, and then the earth connection also goes there. The bridge is loose already. Place it down there and then let it tightened. So it means that we have wired the mains supply that brings in power into the power supply unit. You should always note not to leave conductors stretching out of each of these points. For example, the conductor that is for the earth should not be exposed to an area like this, whereby it can easily touch with any of the conductors. That's an important thing to note, so that you don't end up creating a short circuit between any of the conductors that you are facing into the supply or the power supply unit. So as this is done, it means that when we are ready, we can plug this head into a power supply, a mains power supply, and that will bring power into the system. So this part is done. So the second part, which has to do with the CCTV output, or the output that goes to each of the CCTV cameras, is then all these green points that you find here. This particular power supply unit can feed as many as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 CCTV cameras. So all these 9 points are designations for connecting CCTV cameras. Now, the other day, we looked at how the CCTV camera cable, the power cables, can be prepared. And here is one of the cables we prepared, whereby we said this point is what can go into a camera. When you take a camera, for instance, here is a CCTV camera, whereby this is the power terminal of the CCTV camera. This is a cable we prepared to provide power to the CCTV camera, which we can plug into the camera like this. So this cable is what we are looking at to be able to connect into the power supply unit in order to bring power into the camera. So let's look at how this cable can be wired into the power supply unit for this particular type of power supply unit. So let me bring back the power supply unit. And so, as usual, you would have to pass the cable into the power supply unit. And we also remember that the cables here that are coming into the power supply unit are also polarized. The red, we said, is standing for positive, and the blue is standing for negative polarity for the power supply to the CCTV cameras. And if you can see as well, there is positive and negative label on each of these outputs that I am saying that goes to a camera. So if I want to tap power to a camera from this power supply unit, what I need to do is to put the positive terminal into, there's a hole here where you can lose from the top here, and there's another one that you can lose from the top here. So let me lose the two of them. When you lose them, you can put the cable underneath. When it goes, you tighten it up firmly, and it is there. The negative will also go into it. As it goes, you tighten it also very well. And so that is how you would have wired a camera. When I put in power, as this is correct, when I plug up my power supply, I'll just switch it on, and then power comes into this one, and then my 12 volts output will be ready at this point for the power supply to send to the camera that I'll feed this power to.